Hi, and welcome to the show. Just took off my sunglasses, and I'm ready to proceed. On Thursday, the 14th day in March, 2013, 1:57 Eastern Standard Time. PM, afternoon radio, on your YouTube, with me, your host, Vernon Howell. This is Drive Time, live from New Jersey. And how are you? I did not do a front-end show, so this is the B program. The B program, ladies and gents. Got a lot of stuff to do. So much stuff to do. So many projects that are unfinished. And, you know, on top of having all these projects that are kind of in flux in the world and on the internet, and anything that I choose to do with my time, and there's so many bad choices. It's just endless crap. I just create crap that I've figured out. But on top of all this, there's this other project looming that's not even a project. It's just I have a extreme amount of junk, really. I'm a pre-hoarder. I wouldn't say I'm a hoarder, because there's some amount of organization to it, and I don't have the need to hang on to everything. I've thrown out a bunch of things. I threw out half of my clothes that I had been hoarding. I had clothes in my trunk for over a year. So I picked through, I was like, do I need this in my closet? Let me just get all of my clothes either in this closet or in this thing. And I did. And so I had, that's my clothes. And it's fine. I have more than enough. So I don't have the real hoarding tendencies. But I have, like, pre-hoarders. Almost like, hoarders? Hoarding? My mind went blank. So the hoarding, yeah, but then so I have all these documents and just crap, really. It's just crap, and I would love to one day be able to know, like, what I have 100% where it is, to recall, even if it's, excuse me, I don't know, like a magazine. Like, if I need to look at, like, the June 1994 issue of Rolling Stone, I have that. If I want to keep that, that's something I want to keep. I know where it is, and that it exists here. The idea that everything in its rightful place, like people who are minimalists, which I am not, and I want no part of, but I fancy that what's cool about being a minimalist to them, or what's appealing to them, is the same idea which I'm trying to get at in a non-minimalist structure. Does that make sense? So I think the minimalist is really looking for a system where everything is order. There's order everywhere. And the minimalism is just kind of a way to get to that. The minimalism isn't the be-all, end-all. It's that other thing. It's that idea of, oh, I own X, Y, and Z. I understand X, Y, and Z. I've put all of these things emotionally, mentally, and physically into the places I desire them to exist. Places which I feel that they belong. And that I can easily, without so much as straining, using any mental, capacity really, call them up or physically pick them up whenever I feel like it. That's minimalism, right? The minimalist lifestyle. It's for the birds, if you ask me. But, you know, because I hope that you can get there without having to, you know. I like shit. I like fucking shit. I like picking things up. I like I like to hold something that isn't, you know, covered in battery acid. Poop. Anything else, I like it. I like a stick. Because I look at a stick and I say, that stick could be painted and made to look like a stick that is half red and half blue. And I think that's pretty great. Because you can't, you know, if you see a stick and you say, oh, that's a stick, and that stick needs to just sit in the woods forever. Well, why? Why can't that stick be, why can't I tape that stick to a photo of John Bon Jovi? And then give Bon Jovi a mustache with a Sharpie. And the stick will look like he'll be like a unicorn Bon Jovi. John Bon Unicorn. Not gonna do any better than that today, so thanks for tuning in.